taken as a great privilege and singular honor for me, on your behalf, to invite our chief guest, Honorable Uhuru Kenyatta, Deputy Prime Minister of the Republic of Kenya and also Minister for Finance, to address us. Your Excellency, you're welcome.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me begin by saying it gives me great pleasure to join you this morning on the occasion of this annual general meeting of the African Trade Insurance Agency. And as a country, we feel particularly honored to host such an important gathering. In the case of Kenya, the economy grew by more than 5% in the year 2010. Up from 2.6% in the year 2009. This recovery was driven by growth in virtually all sectors of the economy, including transport and communication, trade and agriculture. Our projections for the year 2011 reveal an even brighter outlook, with GDP expected to grow at approximately 6.1%. I believe this record of positive economic growth is not unique to Kenya, and similar performances have been experienced in other African countries. It is my hope that this momentum in growth will be sustained and that this will translate into better standards of living for our people. However, for this to happen, we must continue to pursue the right policies and focus our energies towards economic development and poverty alleviation, and resolve internal conflicts within our continent, our countries, and within the region. It is against this backdrop that ATI's role in facilitating trade and investment within its member countries through the provision of its risk mitigation products and services becomes invaluable. ATI has also played an important role in supporting regional integration by ensuring cross-border trade and investment transactions. Honorable Ministers, our strength as a continent lies in regional cooperation, as we cannot address the inequities of the global trading environment as individual countries. Reliance on a narrow range of commodities is risky for economic development for well-known reasons, including fluctuations in world market demand and prices, as well as sensitivities to drought and other natural effects on our agriculture. Indeed, in the face of the global economic downturn, failure to diversify our products and economies away from the dependence on a narrow range of commodities obviously would exact a heavy price for the development of our regions. The onus of our governments is now to take concrete steps to create an environment where business will find it easy consider venturing in high-value added exports. ATI provides the mechanism through which African countries and our private sector can achieve this objective. I am also reliably informed that more countries have expressed an interest in joining ATI. These include Nigeria, Senegal, Ethiopia, Sierra Leone, and Gambia, amongst others. I would indeed like to urge these countries to complete the steps required to fulfill their membership so that ATI can begin to do business with them. Allow me, ladies and gentlemen, at this stage, to thank all the shareholders of ATI for their support and the confidence that they have vested in the agency. I wish to recognize the involvement of the AU, the World Bank, the African Development Bank in this endeavor, and for their continued financial and technical support in areas of underwriting and operations. Also, deserving specific mention are the African Union, represented here by His Excellency Mr. Mwecha, for their political support, SACE, the Italian ECA, the Atlantis Group, the Dutch ECA, the EU, and USA. And I wish to also pledge today the commitment of the government of supporting ATI, given our faith in the agency and considering the immense benefits that Kenya and indeed our private sector have gained from ATI. I wish you a successful AGM and wish ATI another great day.